Go over your QBasic tutorial series, Tutorial 7, If Statements. This is the if statement syntax, the relational operators, and all code can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. QB64 running on Windows 7 is used within this tutorial. We'll start with a simple if statement. I'll first clear the screen. If 5 is greater than 2, then go ahead, print 5 is greater than 2. And if. Okay, go ahead, run. We get 5 is greater than 2 on the screen because the condition is met. If 5 is less than 2, I'll go ahead and print 5 is less than 2. I'll go ahead and run. Nothing is printed out on the screen because the condition is not met, because 5 is definitely greater than 2. Okay, within another program, clear the screen, and we'll try if 5 is greater than 10, then go ahead and print 5 is greater than 10. Else, go ahead and print 5 is less than 10. And if, and I'll go ahead and run. The computer responds by stating that 5 is less than 10. Excellent. Within a new program, what I'd like to do is have the user enter in two integers, and we'll check to see which integer is larger than the other. So I'll go ahead and start with dim, and I'll make num1 as integer, and I'll declare num2 as integer. I'll clear the screen, have some input, enter first integer, a comma, and I'll get num1, input, enter second integer, and I'll put that information within num2. If num1 is greater than num2, then we'll print num1 semicolon is greater than, end quotes, semicolon num2. Else, we'll try at this time, print num2 is greater than semicolon num1, and if. Okay, I'll go ahead and run. Start off with 10 as the first integer and 5 as the second. 10 is greater than 5. Okay, I'll rearrange them. So we have 5 as the first integer and 10 as the second. 10 is greater than 5. Excellent. Let's go ahead and try this with 10 and 10. And it says 10 is greater than 10. That is definitely incorrect. And here's the reason why. We have if num1 is greater than num2, which 10 is not greater than 10, so this is not triggered. But we have an else, which is. So what we're going to have to do is try an else if statement. We'll just make a modification here. So we have else if num2 is greater than num1, then we'll go ahead and print that num2 is greater than num1. And here I'll just put in an else, and there's only three possible situations here: that num1 is greater than num2, num2 is greater than num1, or the numbers are the same. So here within this else, we know that this will only trigger if the numbers are the same. So I'll print the numbers are the same. Okay, I'll go ahead and run, and we'll try this again. Start off with 10 and 5. 10 is greater than 5. Good. 5 and 10. Still says 10 is greater than 5. Good. And one more to try this out. We'll try 5 and 5. The numbers are the same. Excellent.